Okay, this next lesson is about using masks to blend images together. So I'm going to bring one of my images into my new document, my bunny. I'm going to close that. And then I need to get the deer out of this picture. So what I'm actually going to do is cut him out, and I'm going to use the magic wand to select the background. I'm going to reduce the tolerance maybe a little bit more. So I'm getting a better cut out. And I just want the head and the antlers. So that looks pretty good. But I actually have the background selected. So what I want to do is go select and go inverse. And then with that selected, pull just the head and the antlers into the other document. Okay, now that I have my images that I'm going to be working with, what I want to do with this second layer, the image that I'm going to blend into, is I want to make it into a mask. So down here on the palette, there is a black square with a little circle that's white. I'm going to click that to make it a mask. So, to align my images, I'm going to reduce the opacity. I'm going to zoom in here. And I am going to enlarge it by transforming it with Command T. Oops, I don't think that helped. Shift. But making sure I hold Shift. And I want the images to be sort of the same size-ish. So I like that. So I'm going to hit Enter to set my transformation. And I'm going to bring this back up to 100%. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go get the paintbrush tool. And again, my mask is white, so I'm going to use a black brush to reveal. And again, I'm going to keep my opacity very low so that it sort of blends in. I'm going to make a very soft brush, and I'm going to reduce the size of my brush, and then I'm just going to paint on that mask layer with the black paint to remove the deer image and fully reveal the bunny. What I'm really looking for is for the head to blend. So because I'm working at 11%, it does mean that it's going to take me longer to blend it and to get rid of that top image, but the results will be much better. And now that I'm happy with where it meets, I can just tidy that up quickly. So there we go. I have a great bunny deer combo. And again, the nice thing about this is if I change my mind and want it to be more of a deer than a bunny, I can switch my colors, I can go back in, and I can bring back in the head of the deer and change the way that I blended my images. And that's why we work in layer masks, because of how we're able to change our mind and switch it, and it's not destructive.